Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. Now guys, the plot continues to thicken in the ongoing Nigerian presidential election saga, which of course you know is at the tribunal stage at the moment, being disputed by Atiku Abubakar. So Atiku Abubakar of course has already now completed his own case, and now it's now the turn of the government and the APC to defend what is being put to them by Atiku. So as part of that defense, obviously Abba Kyari, the Buhari friend and right-hand man, has now been called to take to the witness stand. So now guys, with that, I bring you this. No certificate listed on President Buhari's CV. Chief of Staff Abba Kyari tells Election Petition Tribunal. So that's the headline. Again, no certificate listed on President Buhari's CV. And this statement is being attributed to the Chief of Staff Abba Kyari, and he told this to the Election Petition Tribunal. So that's the headline. Now let's get into exactly what he said. Today, President Buhari's Chief of Staff Abba Kyari admitted before the Presidential Election Petition Tribunal in Abuja that no certificate was listed on the president's curriculum vitae and none was amongst the documents obtained from Cambridge University earlier tendered as exhibits. Kyari, who testified as the president's third defense witness, also admitted obtaining the Cambridge documents personally on July 18, 2019. The People's Democratic Party and its presidential candidate Atiku Abubakar had filed the petition before the tribunal to challenge the victory of President Buhari and his All Progressive Congress in the February 23rd poll. Part of the grounds of the petition was that Buhari does not possess the academic qualification necessary to contest the poll. Under a cross-examination by the petitioner's lawyer, Kyari said he was 67 years old and that he had known Buhari for nearly 40 years. Kyari also said he signed for and collected the Cambridge documents for the assessment by Cambridge. He did not say if he traveled to London to obtain the documents, but he confirmed that none of the documents contained a certificate. He confirmed that the Cambridge documents were assessments, and this assessment is in quotation marks, so not certificates but assessment. He also confirmed that the curriculum vitae signed by Buhari did not have any certificate listed apart from the list of schools attended by the president. He also admitted that the diploma in strategic study, which he claimed Buhari possessed, was not listed in the president's CV. Under cross-examination by APC's lawyer Latif Fagbemi San, Kyari, however, maintained that Atiku was a Cameroonian by being born in Jada in 1946, as of the time of which part of Adamawa State was still a part of northern Cameroon. He also identified Buhari in a picture of those who were said to be the president's classmates and teachers whilst graduating as a class 6 pupil in 1961. So there you have it now. So we now have from the chap that has known him for 40 years and is chief of staff indeed and his right-hand man, and when you're talking about cabal, the first name that you talk about is this Abba Kyari chap. So he is now saying that he has not listed any certificate in the documentations that he submitted to INEC for Buhari, which is effectively what the reading of this would say, because he's saying they were assessments and not certificates. This is effectively what he has said, and the Nigerian constitution requires a certificate to be shown as part of the documentation that is needed to aspire for that post. So now there are two elements in this. Now if a certificate was not listed, then what has INEC done to verify that the document being presented to them complies with the requirements of the constitution of the country, especially the documents that's been submitted to aspire to the most important position and the most important office in the country. So you are taught that they would have checked this thing with a fine-tooth comb and unpicked it completely to make sure that it was fit and proper and it complies to the letter of the Constitution. So now the guy is now telling us that the documents that he submitted were assessments and not certificates. So then how then is INEC able to explain to us that the certificate requirement as stated in the Nigerian Constitution was satisfied in the Buhari's application to submit that he was to vie for the position of president? So first, that query is towards INEC. So then consequently, if the document submitted to INEC does not comply with the requirements of the Constitution, then obviously that then voids that document, you know, because the document does not comply, so therefore they have not met the requirements of the Constitution, so that application is effectively void, and then obviously then his candidature is effectively voided. So now this is really what it should mean, and this is what it does mean, but what it means and what happens are completely two different things in the Nigerian situation, as we're all aware. So now we now have now from the horse's mouth effectively somebody that's known Malam Buhari for 40 odd years and indeed is chief of staff, stating that there were no certificates added, there were no certificates added to the documents that were submitted, because that is the reading of this. So now how this plays out now is anybody's guess, but of course we all know how it's going to pan out. So now conversations in the comment section is what I am inviting around this. No certificate Buhari has now been confirmed from his own right hand man, his man Friday. So now we now know. So now what then happens next is the next question. So come join me to discuss what should or what and what will happen next in the comment section. But before you come have that conversation with me, click on the red subscribe button so it turns gray. Bell button notifies you every time I drop a new video. Then come tell me what you are making of all of this palaver in the comment section. So I'll leave you here, carry on with you in the comment section, but here I say peace.